This is the Big O Show. This is the Big O Show. Let me tell you, the Dolphins, okay? The Dolphins have earned this from me, just like the Miami Heat, all right? After last year, when I see you find Preston Williams off street free agency and you get me Nick Needham, who looked absolutely terrible at the beginning, but then, I mean, he became a serviceable player. And you're like, okay, wait a minute. You just found depth at corner. This guy can play in the NFL. This guy could be your fourth or fifth corner, right? I'm not telling you Nick Needham's a start or anything like that, but I think he could be a really nice backup for you, right? So that happens, and I'm like, okay, that's, you know, finding Hassan Whiteside. That's finding Briante Weber. That's finding, now, Tyler. That's, well, Tyler's a draft pick, but Duncan Robinson. You know, things like that. That's getting Kendrick Nunn off somebody else's practice squad. That's where, when you're the Miami Heat,
turning something into nothing, man, and that is so hard.
I don't know about you guys, and again, our show, I want to be out at Summer League. Now, you don't mind going to Vegas, right, for Summer League, right? Vegas? Vegas.
When are we going?
Okay. All right.
My bag has been sitting, waiting, ready, packed.
But I don't know about you guys, but again, I'm a hardcore sports fan, which a lot of you that are watching, that's why you're watching, because you're hardcore like I am. That's why we want to grow this show, have real sports, because there's no real sports shows on some of these other stations anyways. So I have become the guy every year now that I watch Summer League religiously, because I want to see who's the next guy that they're trying to develop that might become a rotational player, that might end up becoming a starter. Why? Because they know how to find people. Now, if you never find people, then I don't watch Summer League. And if you never find people, then I don't look at your street free agents that are undrafted that you signed. But yesterday, after I got the list, I went and sent some texts to some of the guys this morning, all that. And I said, all right, here you go. What do you know about some of these? Why? Because you did it last year to me now. You showed me that you can find people after the draft. So now that I know you can scout like the Heat, okay, now I got to pay attention to this. So in a way, the Miami Dolphins took a page from the Miami Heat in no toki. I say nothing. You hear nothing. They pulled the Schultz, right? And it worked. Smoke screens everywhere. The media just invented shit and ruined it all, right? And helped the Dolphins in the process, which was great.
I'd like to thank Marino for going over the edge and cluing O in.
And now,
so he could clue us in.
Exactly. And now I'm watching the Dolphins take another page from the Miami Heat and say, no, no, wait a minute. It's not just about draft picks or trades. We can find players in other places. Street free agency, undrafted free agency, somebody else's practice squad. We're going to find players. If we find one in the CFL, we'll bring them in. I wouldn't be surprised if these cats find somebody in the CFL that can play in Miami in the next couple of years, like Mark Dixon, like Cam Wake. We've done it in the past, right? Why can't you do it again? So when I look at this list and I start going Kirk Merritt and Matt Cole and Bryce Sterk and Donnell Stanley and Nick Kaltmeyer and Benito Jones and Ray Lima and Tyshawn Render, I'm not going, training camp fodder. No, no, no. No, no, no. That's changed. That has changed. Now I look at it and I go, let me look closer, because these guys know what the hell they're doing. So that's changed.